Hello, my name is Jasmine. I'm the teen librarian at the Lamont Public Library District. Today I'm going to be sharing with you a few new teen fiction and graphic novels for the month of September that you'll be able to find here at the library. At the end, I'll also be telling you about teen programs we are offering this fall and service hour opportunities that you might be interested in. Let's get started. A British Girl's Guide to Hurricanes and Heartbreak by Laura Taylor Namy. Winchester, England has always been home for Flora, but when her mother dies after a long illness, Flora finds herself untethered. Her family expects her to apply to university and take a larger role in their tea shop business, but Flora isn't so sure. More than ever, she's a chaotic hurricane in her household, and she doesn't always know how to manage her stormy emotions. So she decides to escape to Miami without telling anyone, especially her longtime friend Gordon Wallace. But Flora's tropical change of scene doesn't cast away her self-doubt. When it comes to university, she has no idea which passion she should follow. That's also true in romance. Flora's summer abroad lands her in the flashbulb world of teen influencer Baz Martin, a Miami Cuban who shares her love for photography. But Flora is more conflicted than ever when she begins to see future architect Gordon in a new light. Laura Taylor Namy's newest novel navigates heartbreak that feels like a hurricane in a city that is famous for them. Reader likes include We Ship It by Laura Kay and Check and Mate by Allie Hazelwood. Percy Jackson and the Olympians, The Chalice of the Gods, Book 6 by Rick Riordan. The original heroes from The Lightning Thief are reunited for their biggest challenge yet, getting Percy to college when the gods are standing in his way. After saving the world multiple times, Percy Jackson is hoping to have a normal senior year. Unfortunately, the gods aren't quite done with him. Percy will have to fulfill 3 quests in order to get the necessary 3 letters of recommendation from Mount Olympus for college. The first quest is to help Zeus's cupbearer receive his goblet before it falls into the wrong hands. Can Percy, Grover, and Annabeth find it in time? Readers new to Percy Jackson and fans who have been awaiting the reunion for more than a decade will delight equally in this latest hilarious take on Greek mythology. Reader likes include The Alchemist by Michael Scott and The Immortal Game by Talia Rothschild. Champions of Fate by Kendar Blake. Behind every great hero is an Aristine. Aristine are mystical female warriors, part of a legendary order. Though heroes might be immortalized in stories, it's the Aristine who guide them to victory. They are the hero makers. Ever since she was an orphan, taken in by the order, Reed has wanted to be an Aristine. Now as an initiate, just one challenge stands in her way. She must shepherd her first hero to glory on the battlefield. Succeed, and Reed will take her place beside her sisters. Fail, and she'll be cast from the only home she's ever known. Nothing is going to stop Reed until she meets her hero. Hestion is fiery and infuriating, but what begins as an alliance becomes more. And as secrets of the Order come to light, Reed begins to understand what becoming an Aristine may truly cost. Battle looming, she must choose the order and the life she had planned, or Hestion, and the one she never expected. Reader likes include Red Tigress by Emile Wen Zhao and Stardust in Their Veins by Laura Sebastian. The Changing Man by Tommy Okimakindi. Face front, watch your back, be brave. If it was left to her, Ife Abedonla won't be starting at Nithercroft School, because despite being the Urban Achievers Scholarship Program, her parents can barely afford the tuition. No matter who, like her classmate, Bijao, is trying to be friends with her, or how much the prestigious boarding school tries to pull her in, Ife is determined not to get caught up in any of it. But when another student, Malika, begins acting strange, Ife can't help but wonder if there's more going on at Neftercroft than she realizes. Could there be any truth to the school's decade-old legend of the Changing Man? Is there any connection to the missing older brother of her classmate, Ben? As more questions arise, Efi has no choice but to team up with Ben and Bijal to investigate. But can the trio act quickly enough to uncover who is behind everything? Before one or all of them is the Changing Man's next victim. Read alikes include All Your Twisted Secrets by Diana Urban and They Wish They Were Us by Jessica Goodman. The Collectors, stories by A.S. King. From David Leviathan's story about a non-binary kid collecting pieces of other people's collections, to Jenny Torres's Sanchez's tale of a girl collecting types of fire while trying not to get burned, to Jean Nery's piece about 1970s skaters seeking opportunities to go viral, anything can be collected, and in the hands of these award-winning and best-selling authors, any collection can tell a story. 9 of the best YA novelists working today have written fiction based on a prompt from Pritzker winner A.S. King, who also contributes a story, and the results is itself an extraordinary collection. Read-alikes include 145th Street by Walter Dean Myers and Three Sides of a Heart by Natalie C. Parker. Find Him Where You Left Him Dead by Christine Simmons. At dawn, he'll be gone and you'll be here forever. 4 years ago, 5 kids started a game. Not all of them survived. Now at the end of their senior year of high school, the survivors, Owen, Madeline, Emerson, and Dax, have reunited for one strange and terrible night. They've summoned the ghost Ian, the friend they left for dead. Together they return to the place where their friendship ended with one find and will find Ian and bring him home. So they restart the deadly game they never finished. An innocent card-matching challenge called Mierdo, a game without instructions. As soon as they begin, they're dragged out of their reality into an eerie hellscape of Japanese underworlds, more horrifying than ever. The deadly folktales that Owen's grandmother told him. There they meet Shinigami, an old wise woman who explains the rules. They have one night to complete 7 challenges or they're all stuck in this world forever. Once inseparable, the survivors now can't stand each other, but the challengers demand they work together, think quickly, and make sacrifices. Blood, clothes, secrets, memories, and worse. And once again, not everyone will make it out alive. Read-alikes include Someone Is Always Watching by Kelly Armstrong and You're Not Supposed to Die Tonight by Caitlin Barron. Foul Heart Huntsman by Chloe Gong. Winter is drawing thick in 1932 Shanghai, as is the ever-nearing threat of a Japanese invasion. Rosalind Lang has suffered the worst possible fate for a national spy. She's been exposed. With the media storm camped outside her apartment for the infamous Lady Fortune, she's barely left her bedroom in weeks, plotting her next course of action after Orion was taken and his memories of Rosalind wiped. Though their marriage might have been a sham, his absence hurts her more than any physical wound. She won't rest until she gets him back. But with her identity in the open, the task is near impossible. The only way to leave the city and rescue Orion is under the guise of a national tour. It's easy to convince her supervisors that the countryside needs unity more than ever, and who better than an immortal girl to stir pride and strength into the people. When the tour goes wrong, however, everything Rosalind once knew was thrown up in the air. Taking refuge outside Shanghai, old ghosts come into the open and adversaries turn to allies. To save Orion, they must find a cure to his mother's traitorous invention and take this dangerous chemical weapon away from impending foreign invasion. But the clock is ticking, and as Rosalind fails, it's not only Orion she loses, but her nation itself. Read-alikes include What the River Knows by Isabel Ibanez and Court of Shadows by Madeline Rue. Goddess Crown by Shay Lapit. Calliope has grown up in the shadows of her kingdom, hidden away in the forested east after her parents were outed as enemies of the king. Raised in a woodland ideal by a few kindly adult caretakers, Calliope can hunt and fish and fend for herself, but knows little of the outside world. When the assassins attack her home on her 16th birthday, she must flee to the king's court in the west, a beautiful but lethal nest of poison, plots, and danger, overseen by an entrenched patriarchy. Guided by the goddess herself, can Calliope navigate this most worldly of places to find her own role? What if she must choose between her country and her heart? Excitement, romance, and a charismatic heroine shine in this first book set in the unforgettable kingdom of Gala. Read-alikes include Shatter by April Lynn Pike and Stone Cold by Sarah Humphreys. Razzball by Byron Graves. This compelling debut novel by new talent Byron Graves tells the relatable, high-stakes story of a young athlete determined to play like the hero his OBGYN community needs him to be. These days, Tri Brune is happiest when he's playing basketball and on the Red Lake Reservation High School team, even though he can't help but he constantly gut punched with the memory of his big brother Jax, who died in an accident. When Jax's former teammates on the varsity team offer to take Trey under their wing, he sees this as his shot to represent OBGYN Res all the way to their first state championship. This is the first step toward his dream of playing in the NBA. No matter how much the odds are stacked against him, but stepping into his brother's shoes as a star player means that Trey can't mess up. Not on the court, not at school, and not with his new friend, gamer Kiliana, who he is definitely not falling in love with. After decades of Res teams almost making it, Trey needs to take his team to state, because if he can't live up to Jax's dreams, their story isn't over yet. This book is published by Hard Drum, an imprint that publishes high-quality contemporary stories about indigenous young people in the United States and Canada. Read-alikes include Four Faces of the Moon by Amanda Strong and Billy Buckhorn and The Book of Spells by Gary Robinson. A Pretty Impossible Premise by Karen Rivers, an unforgettable story of loss, love, and for fans of Dandy Nelson and Nina LaCour. When Hattie and Presley meet, it's basically love at first sight. Head spinning, can't stop thinking about each other feelings. Their instant connection seems at first impossible. It starts to seem impossible when they realize everything they have in common. Both are grieving, living in worlds haunted by ghosts. Both have a difficult relationship with one of their parents, and both were forced to give up on their Olympic dreams. Hattie and Presley find comfort in each other, But like the wildfires that surround their California town, the trauma that haunts their past can't be held off for long. Can they help each other move through it without breaking apart? Read-alikes include Viva la Espinosa by Ella Corazon and Make the Fireflies Dance by Rachel Bateman. On to graphic novels. My Hero Academia Volume 35 by Keihoi Hoikashi. The ultimate war between heroes and villains looms in the near future as both sides regroup. Japan's heroes weave the plans in the lead-up, but will spies within UA give it all away? The Hero Course students will have their parts to play as well, and Midori himself has a major role. If things work out, the heroes are hoping to divide and conquer, but even the best-laid plans rarely survive contact with the enemy. Read-alikes include Haiku by Hirochi Furudat and Buroto by Yuko Hadachi. The 21 by Elizabeth Rusch. From severe flooding in Louisiana to wildfires in the Pacific Northwest to melting permafrost in the Atlantic and in Alaska, catastrophic climate events are occurring more frequently and severely than ever. And these events are having a direct impact on the lives and futures of young people and their families. In the ongoing landscape case, Juliana versus the United States, 21 young plaintiffs claim that the government's support of the fossil fuel industry is actively contributing to climate change, and that all citizens have a constitutional right to stable climate, especially children and young adults, because they cannot vote and they will inherit the problems of the future. Elizabeth's Which is The 21 is a gripping legal and environmental thriller that tells the story of a 21 young people and their ongoing case against the U.S. government for denying their constitutional right to life and liberty. A rich, informative, and multifaceted read. The 21 starts the young plaintiffs and their attorneys. Illuminating the works of the United States judicial system and the relationship between government, citizens' rights, and the environment, and asks readers to think deeply about the future of their planet. The 21 is for readers of Christine Schnurrbart's Aw-13, fans of Steve Sheinkin's books, and anyone interested in the environment, climate change, as well as youth activism, politics and government, and the law. This fall, for tween and teen programs are offering D&D, Super Smash Bros, teen tournaments, spooky cookie decorating, teen teacher shelf. We're also doing 100 books before graduation, where you read through, where you read 100 books before graduating, log them through your Beanstack account, and win prizes on the way to 100. For service hours, we have our At Your Service and Teen Volunteer Squad programs, and our Character Pen Pal letter writing program, where you can come in and pick up a kit to write letters to children as their favorite character. We also have book reviews and advanced reader book reviews, where they get to keep the title after reviewing it. I also make Teen Taken Makes each month, if you are looking for a quick craft to complete at home. If you would like any more information about programs or service hour opportunities, you can contact me at jwilkerson@lamontlibrary.org. Thank you and have a great day.